Hello and welcome. Next, we are going to see the iterator protocol. What is it all about? It is all about iterating over objects. So iteration protocols, what are those? Set of rules that objects need to follow in order for a loop to go over the values of the objects. There are two protocols, iterator and iterable. Iterator protocol is what we are going to see in this session. An object is an iterator when it implements a next method with the following. Property name is next with no arguments, and it returns an object with two properties, done, which is a Boolean value, and value, which is any JavaScript value. Now, done is true if the iterator is past the end of the iterated sequence, and done is false if the iterator is able to produce the next value in the sequence. You will come to know once we write the code for this. So let's start with a blank slate. As always, I will delete this thing. Now I will start with an object. Let obj is equal to, I create one object. In this object, I put a property which is an array. So this property will contain v, comma, all, comma, love, comma, JavaScript or ES6, comma, and the last one will be iterators. Okay, this is a simple array and it's a property in this object. The next one is count. Now count is a variable, is a property which has value 0. It's integer, okay? And the next one is a function that is called next. As you saw in the PPT, this is a function. So I will put it as an anonymous function now. Function in, and I complete the curly brace here itself so that we don't miss the curly braces anywhere. And I say if in the bracket, this dot count is less than this dot array dot length. Okay, so here we are comparing whether the count which we have is less than the array length, that is array which has been declared above, which contains we all love ES6 iterators. So here it will compare. And then if it is true, it will execute this if statement. So what is there in the if statement? Let's see. So I have console.log. Rather than putting console.log over here, let me just return it. Return value. Here I am returning a value. In fact, I am returning an object which has value as one of its property, and this value will be this dot array, and in bracket I have this dot count plus plus. Okay. Now the next one is comma. I say next in this object is a property called done, and done is set to false. And I complete this one. So this is what we are returning from this if statement. If this if statement is true, we are returning this object which has value and done as two properties of the object, and it done has the value of false. So this is complete. Here we put a semicolon and then we complete the if block. So the next one is the else block, and in the else block what we say is we return another object where we have one property called done, which we saw earlier, and this property will now be set to true. So that's all, and we have everything completed over here. we have this function completed, and so this is done. Now the next thing we need to do is complete this code. So next thing in the code is this completing brace, and this completes the let statement. So once we complete this object, we have a while loop. Now why do we have a while loop? You will come to know in a minute. So I have this while loop over here, while obj dot count dot, sorry, not dot, it's less than obj dot array dot length. Okay, and then I have this curly braces. So why do we have this check? Because we want to iterate, and we want to iterate till the array length is not met. So we put a console.log over here, and we put obj dot next, remember to put these, and then I put dot value. That's all. And finally, we put another console.log for obj.next.value and obj.next.done, so that you will come to know what are the values after exiting this while loop. Okay, save this and run it. Okay, now F12. F12 will bring the console. So what do we have? We all love ES6 iterators, and then after coming out of the while loop, it has a value of undefined. Why? Because we have already crossed the array elements. Now there is undefined in the variable that has, that holds the array elements, and the value of done is true after exiting the while loop. So that's it. That's how we do iterator in JavaScript, and this is how we iterate over the values using the next function. The next function has two variables. First is the done, which is a boolean, and the next one is the value that holds the actual value which is present in the object at that time. So this is how you do iterators in JavaScript. Next, we will be looking into iterable in JavaScript in ES6. So stay tuned. Thank you very much.